Just to harp back on Danny in 168, I mean, there's a really interesting fight there, I think, and it's a rematch, and it's him versus Kid Chocolate. Kid Chocolate's about to fight for a title. He could be champ at 168. That'll make for a good narrative right there. Is that something you guys have even processed or thought of?
No, I haven't, but honestly, I think the outcome, another draw?
Yeah.
I think the outcome would pretty much be in the same vein. Mm-hmm. He already fought him. He went and devastated him. And I like Kid Chocolate. I don't want to see them fight again. I really don't. But if they were to, I think the end results would be very similar.
Even though, like, Kid at that time, I said he was super drained making 160 in it.
Well, you know, everybody has something to say. Mm-hmm. I would appreciate the first fighter who told me, you know what, I lost because I lost.
Yeah.
The guy was just better, and that's it. No excuses. Don't carry me on the gravy train with an excuse. If you lost, you lost. Let's leave it at that.
Let's drop down some pounds from 168 to 135. Your guy, IBF champ, Mr. Comey. How are we looking with him?
Richard Comey. He's in the crowd right now, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Richard is the most wonderful fighter anybody could ever have as a fighter. He works harder than anybody that I've ever seen. He never has a complaint, and he wants to be special. God gave him a gift of incredible punching power. My job was to refine it and define it, make sure that he can articulate and land that and create those spectacular knockouts. And that's what I've been doing. He's a joy to work with. He will be fighting on June 28th against Ray Beltran.
Former champion.
And I tell you this, it's going to be a rough night for Ray Beltran.
Not you.
A rough night.